William Gilbert, a British medical doctor and natural philosopher, was born in 1544 and died in 1603. Scientists of his time were called natural philosophers. Gilbert studied what earlier philosophers had written about electricity and magnetism. He performed experiments and developed his own ideas about electricity and magnetism. In 1600, Gilbert wrote a book in Latin that we call De Magnete. In his book, he summarized what was written by his predecessors, described his experiments, and presented his ideas. He used the Latin word electricus, meaning like amber, to describe static electricity. Here are some of William Gilbert's most important beliefs and contributions to the science of electricity and magnetism. Gilbert believed experiments are important. The earth is a magnet and a compass does not point to a star. The center of the earth is iron. Electricity and magnetism are two different phenomena. Friction removes something when amber is rubbed to create an electrical charge. He recognized that effect is unique to electricity and does not apply to magnetism. He discovered that cutting a magnet makes two magnets. He invented an instrument to detect electricity. He called it a versorium. His beliefs were based on study, research, and experiments. He presented good arguments to support them. However, as often happens with science, some of his ideas that I have not mentioned were later proved to be incorrect. Nevertheless, his work represents a major milestone in the advancement of knowledge about electricity and magnetism. A versorium is like a compass, but the needle can be any metal. It does not need to be iron. A copper versorium is shown here. When a negatively charged plastic pipe is brought near the versorium, the negative charge drives away the negatively charged electrons in the metal needle, and the remaining positive charges are attracted by the pipe. This works for either end of the versorium. The needle cannot be permanently charged at one end. You can make a versorium with a twist tie, a piece of cardboard, and a sewing pin. It is just like the compass that was made in another video in this series. The versorium does not need to be magnetized. If it is magnetized, it will still work as a versorium. The fact that the needle is magnetized does not change its electrical behavior. The electrostatic force is stronger than the magnetic force. A charged object pulls the compass away from pointing north. Thank you for watching, and please visit wiscimuseum.org. Thank you.